course, all that must wait until Corypheus himself is defeated. Was there anything else, Inquisitor?
Go fuck yourself. Yeah, yeah, sounds good. Okay.
Inquisitor.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Thank the Maker, you're here. Morrigan chased after her son into the Illuvian. She was terrified.
She was chasing Kira.
She said he activated the mirror somehow, and then she ran into it. I've never seen Morrigan like that. You must go after her. I will find help, Inquisitor.
All right.
Wait. This isn't the crossroads. This is the Fade. How did the Illuvian lead here? Can it go anywhere?
I think that there's something Morgan isn't telling me.
Morrigan!
Go back! I must find Kieran before it's too late. Why would Kieran do this? How could he do this? We stand in the Fade. To direct the Illuvian here would require immense power. If he is lost to me now, after all I have sacrificed...
We'll find him, Morrigan. He can't be far.
Why are we so dirty?
The Fade is infinite. He could literally be anywhere. Whatever happens to him now, it is my doing. I set him on this path. Please, help me look, Inquisitor. Just a little longer.
Sure, baby.
There he is!
Who's with him?
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Mother!
Mother. Now, isn't this a surprise?
So this is all some kind of family reunion.
Mother, daughter, grandson. It rather warms the heart, does it not?
Kieran is not your grandson. Let him go.
As if I were holding the boy hostage. She's always been ungrateful, you see.
Ungrateful? I know how you plan to extend your life, wicked crone. You will not have me, and you will not have my son.
That's quite enough. You'll endanger the boy.
Well, shit. Oh, or not.
What have you done to me?
I have done nothing. You drank from the well of your own volition.
You are Mathal.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, that was unexpected.
You, of all people, should expect the unexpected by now.
I'm sorry, Mother. I heard her calling to me. She said now was the time.
I do not understand.
Once I was but a woman, crying out in the lonely darkness for justice. And she came to me, a wisp of an ancient being, and she granted me all I wanted and more. I have carried Mythol through the ages ever since, seeking the justice denied to her.
Then you carry Mythol inside you?
She is a part of me, no more separate than your heart from your chest. You hear the voices of the well, girl. What do they say?
They say you speak the truth.
But what was Mythol? A legend given name and called a god? Or something more? Truth is not the end, but a beginning. So young and vibrant, you do the people proud and have come far. As for me, I have had many names, but you may call me Flemeth.
Technically,
I know the name Flemeth. My people call you Ashabelinar, the woman of many years, and speak of your legend. It says long ago you left your husband for a lover. Your husband then tricked you, killed your lover, and imprisoned you. Then a spirit came to offer you vengeance. Mythol, that's what you spoke of.
One day someone will summarize the terrible events of your life so quickly. But yes, I was that woman. That is how my tale began.
Flemeth appears in other legends, helping heroes for reasons of her own.
I nudge history when it's required. Other times, a shove is needed.
If Mythol is a part of you, why haven't you helped us? We've called to you, prayed to you.
What was could not be changed.
What about now? You know so much.
You know not what you ask, child.
Why did Mythol come to you?
For a reckoning that will shake the very heavens.
And you follow her whims? Do you even know what she truly is?
You seek to preserve the powers that were, but to what end? It is because I taught you, girl. Because things happened that were never meant to happen.
She was betrayed as I was betrayed, as the world was betrayed. Mythol clawed and crawled her way through the ages to me, and I will see her avenged!
Alas, so long as the music plays, we dance.
So you lured us here. What do you want?
One thing, and one thing only.
The USS Voyager?
I have to go now, Mother.
Oh. All right.
No. I will not allow it.
He carries a piece of what once was, snatched from the jaws of darkness. You know this.
He is not your pawn, Mother. I will not let you use him!
Have you not used him? Was that not your purpose? The reason you agreed to his creation?
That was then. Now he is my son. Flemeth extends her life by possessing the bodies of her daughters, Inquisitor. That was the fate she intended for me. I thwarted her. And now she intends to have Kieran instead.
Wait, the way she talked about Kieran.
I am not the only one carrying the soul of a being long thought lost.
He is more than that, Mother.
As am I. Yet do you hear me complain? Our destinies are not so easily avoided, dear girl.
Mother, I have to.
You do not belong to her, Kieran. Neither of us do.
If Kieran is so special, why did you wait until now to come for him?
I did not know where he was. Morrigan cleverly hid him from me. Until now.
It was the well.
Always grasping beyond your reach, despite all that I taught you.
You're going to steal the body of a young boy.
If my daughter believes it, Then it must be so.
Kieran, I...
That's my son.
As you wish. Hear my proposal.
Oh no, don't sacrifice Morgan.
Let me take the land, and you are free of me forever. I will never interfere with or harm you again. Or keep the lad with you, and you will never be safe from me. I will have my due.
I will take my chances.
I found you once, girl. What makes you think I will not find you again?
Take over my body now, if you must. Just let Kieran go.
Oh.
He'll be better off without me. Just as I was better off without you.
No.
No more dreams. A soul is not forced upon the unwilling, Morrigan. You were never in danger from me. Listen to the voices. They will teach you, as I never did.
Wait!
I'm so confused. Okay. That was some weird ass shit.
Are you all right, Kieran? You are not hurt.
I feel lonely.
Okay.
No. She wanted old god soul all along. Is it worth reminding myself that perhaps I do not know everything after all? My mother has the soul of an elven goddess, or whatever Mithal truly was, and her plans are unknown to me.
So Kieran had the soul of an old god?
Taken from the Archdemon at the final battle of the Fifth Blight. Yes, he has never known anything else. I'm uncertain what effect this will have on him.
But why did you...
I told you at the temple, the magic of old must be preserved, no matter how feared. Kieran had a destiny, and now it is in Flemeth's hands. I suppose we shall see what she does with it.
So what happens now?
Now we must prepare to face Corypheus himself. It seems Mother was right. The voices of the well tell me I will be able to match his dragon. All that remains is for you to find him.
Mother must be very pleased. If I see her again, I will have no choice but to do every single thing she commands. I feel certain what happened at the Temple of Mithal must somehow have been her influence.
You might be right.
'Twas a temple dedicated to her, after all. Is it a coincidence we ended up there? There must be a connection we cannot see. I suppose we have little choice but to proceed and be thankful she assisted us at all.
Do you trust what Flemeth told us?
About what she is? I am uncertain. I knew there was more to her than I realized, that she was not truly human. This? I once found her grimoire, and that was where I learned her immortality was gained by stealing the bodies of her daughters. Flemeth claims I misunderstood. It is not forced on the unwilling.
Meaning I might agree to such a thing? Impossible, yet there seemed an undeniable sense of truth to the things she told us. All my years spent hunting for arcane mysteries, and the greatest was the one I left behind.
So what do you intend to do now?
Once Corypheus is defeated, I will undoubtedly move on. Where I will go is uncertain. I must consider the fact that Flemeth may yet have plans for me. I am, after all, her servant. Such a delight. Yet we must now consider the coming battle. I hope all I learned from the well proves worthwhile.
I'd like to know more about...
If you have questions, then ask.
Is this it? Is this what it's come down to? Okay.
Did you find what you need, Morrigan?
I can match the Darkspawn Magister's dragon. Yes. As for matching Corypheus, that is up to you, Inquisitor.
I'm eager to try.
Then all that remains is to find Corypheus before he comes to us.
We've been looking for his base since all this began, with no success.
His dragon must come and go from somewhere.
Oh, what about the Deep Roads? We could send word to Orzammar, a higher envoys too.
I'm so awesome. Like... Jeez. The Breach?
It seems Corypheus is not content to wait.
He's in the Valley of Sacred Ashes.
You either close the breach once more, or it swallows the world.
But that's madness. Wouldn't it kill him as well?
Inquisitor, we have no forces to send with you. We must wait for them to return from the Arbor Wilds.
I must go now, before it's too late.
Well, shit.
Tell me, where is your maker now? Call him. Call down his wrath upon me. You cannot, for he does not exist. I am Corypheus. I shall deliver you from this lie in which you linger. Bow before your new god and be spared.
Never!
As you.
Hey, seems like he's okay. Ooh. Oh. Maybe not. Yeah, there you go. Oh, well, shit.
I knew.
It ends here, Corypheus.
And so it shall.
Was that Harding? Oh. Well. I suppose there's no more last-minute sex with Cassandra, unless we do
you
it on the floor here.
Successful in foiling my plans, but let us not forget what you are. A thief in the wrong place, at the wrong time, an interloper, a gnat. We shall prove here, once and for all, which of us is worthy of godhood.
I came here to stop you, Corypheus. Nothing more.
Okay. Let's kiss now. Oh. Yeah. Yeah! Thank you, Morgan. Yes, I dare.
A dragon! How clever of you! It will avail you nothing! You will fall as a warning to those who oppose my divine will. Enough! I will destroy you where you stand.
Okay. So, let's start with a little something I like to call... armoring up.
I will not stand for this outrage.
Oh, knock me the fuck out, huh?
Enough. I will destroy you where you stand.
There we go. Oh, is it time to move forward? Or is he coming down?
Look at you, wearing slave markings on your face with pride. You are nothing. A race.
Everybody follow me.
An avatar of divinity.
Can we regroup?
Defend our power.
No? We're just going to run around and be crazy? Because I guess we could do that. I don't suggest that. Alright. How's that feel, huh? I guess we're going up, right? Nice! I don't need a supply catch. Ah, yes.
I shall sear you from the very heavens. You dare to touch an avatar of divinity? Feel my wrath.
No! No! Jesus. Oh man, don't die. We can kill it. We can do this.
Yeah.
Okay. Come on, she's got it, right? No, not yet. Oh boy. Okay. Can't do it yet, damn it. Alright. Oh my god, Doran, you gotta get out of the way, man. Come on. What? No bows. Okay.
Let it end here. Let the skies boil. Let the world be rent asunder.
Well, shit. Oh my god, he's at full health. Oh, god damn it. Please tell me there's a supply catch. Okay. Oh god, he's at half health now.
Breach is getting bigger!
He's really doing it. We have to stop him!
Oh shit, really? Oh, okay. Oh, he oh, son of a bitch! I also want to throw that at him. Oh man, I missed. Oh shit.
Not like this. I have walked the halls of the Golden City, crossed the ages. Ancient ones, I beseech you. If you exist, if you ever truly existed, aid me now.
It's mine.
Into the fade.
Solus?
The orb.
Are you sure? We could take the pieces. Try to...
That would not recover what has been lost.
There's more, isn't there?
It was not supposed to happen this way. No matter what comes, I want you to know you shall always have my respect.
Inquisitor, are you alive?
Hey, she's alive.
Victorious, I see. What a novel result.
And you survive. Thank the Maker.
And it seems the breach is finally closed.
Looks that way.
What do we do now?
We go back to Skyhold.
Please don't end it like this.
A moment, my lord. My agents have found no trace of Solus. He has simply vanished. If he does not wish to be found, there's likely nothing we can do. But I will keep looking.
Why would he just leave? Something must be wrong.
You said he was upset about the orb.
That can't be the only reason.
Now that Corypheus has been defeated, we have a moment to stop and celebrate. Afterwards, you will be busy. Every noble in southern Thedas is clamoring to meet you.
As the saying goes, to the victor go the spoils.
They see more than victory. Previously, you were an upstart, a Dalish elf leading a band of rebels and heretics. Until Corypheus revealed himself, they could not see the single hand behind the chaos. Once he did, they knew. A magister and a darkspawn in one creature. The ultimate evil. Now you are the only power left standing. Enjoy the evening while you can, Inquisitor.
Okay. Who do we even start with?
Am I imagining it? Or do we have a moment to breathe?
I can scarcely believe it.
The Conclave, Haven. It seems so long ago. You should hear the stories they're telling in the barracks. The pride in their voices. Some of the soldiers have requested leave to return home, but many would follow us still. You are proof that the Inquisition has made a difference, and that we will continue to do so.
Our soldiers put their trust in you, Cullen. I appreciate everything you've done.
I should be thanking you. You gave me a chance to prove myself. In your place, I'm not sure I would have done the same. I should let you mingle. I'm sure everyone desires your attention. Enjoy the party, Inquisitor.
Can I open that door? I can't go through it. Damn it.
All this pomp and ceremony. Can't top seeing that bastard Corypheus burn. No matter what happens to me now, I can say I was there. I helped you bring him down.
It took all of us, but we did it.
I shudder to think where we'd be without you leading us. So now that you've saved the world, what's next? Hoping to put it all back together?
Someone has to fix things. Might as well be me.
If anyone can do it, you can. If you ever need my help, you know where to find me. I'll be ready.
Retire to my quarters? That sounds so suspicious.
That was the Tevinterist vent in the history of all vents. The original mold from which subsequent vents were cast. And I got to help kick the shit out of him. Good times, boss. Good times.
There's no one I would have rather had at my side, Bull.
Same here. I got to kill another dragon and fight a vent. Those poor bastards on the ground had demons. It's weird. I joined the Inquisition under orders from the Ben Hasrath and stayed because Corypheus was an asshole. Now that it's done, I've got no orders. For the first time in my life, I can go wherever I want.
Got anywhere in mind?
If it's all the same with you, I'm pretty good right here.
Anyway,
the only place I'm going tonight is back for more drinks. To us, being alive, and the bad guys not.
He totally missed his mouth. Good for him.
They're all happy. There's still fear.
That is really shiny bread.
You helped them all. You healed what was hurt. They don't want to forget what happened, even if it gives them nightmares. It would hurt less, but it matters to them.
The fear reminds people of what they fought for. It gives the victory significance.
It's part of being people. I know. I don't understand, but they need it. I think I could return to the Fade if I tried. I'm light enough to slip through, but I'd like to stay and help for a while, if that's all right. I can still help people here.
Tonight, we remind the world and each other that we're alive.
Yes. Because of you. Thank you for letting me stay.
Finally got a party, yeah? A bit of fun for saving the world.
What's she even...
The least Andraste's Herald deserves for making things normal again. Except for, you know, everything ever again. I mean... Is this for us, or for her? Or, you know, him? Because I was there, and I still don't know what's real.
Couldn't it be his will and our effort? Perhaps miracles need a little help.
Well, what's the friggin' point of them, then? Ugh, you sound like a sister. I guess you'd know by this point. Seems like you did it right, mostly. Still some things to do yet, right? Because I'm in no hurry to go back to... Valrio, that's where I was. You mind if people still stay around? Or whatever?
This is home, if you'll have it.
Shut it, you! I cry, I'm punching everyone. Alright, enough of that. Is this a party or what? Raise them for winning! Big freaking heroes, Inquisitor. All of us.
Yep. Is everyone here? Okay, just making sure Cassandra's over there. Where is Vivian? Okay, she's over there. Okay.
I was passing through the hall this morning and a serving girl saw me and squealed. Actually squealed, dropped her laundry and everything. Such a mess. She was completely breathless. You were at the battle with the evil one, weren't you? I didn't even get a chance to answer. She hugged me. Hugged me. This is your influence.
That's what happens when you're a hero.
Is that so? Must be why it's so unfamiliar. Mind you, I can't say I hate the notion of being the good Tevinter. I suppose you can't all be evil bastards. The blacksmith said that, and he spat when we first met. I hope my father hears. He will shit his small clothes from shock, I swear.
Will you be returning to Tevinter now?
No, actually. I was thinking of sticking around for a while.
Would that have anything to do with Iron Bull?
It might. You know how it is. Plus, what would you do without me?
How will I ever know unless you go?
Clever. See?
Yep.
I keep your wits sharp.
Oh, I should never have hired new caterers so late.
Leave it be, Josie. Everything's fine.
It is not! I'm so sorry. Nothing's quite as it should be. Do you like the drinks? I'm not sure about them.
The drinks are fine. It's been a wonderful evening.
I hope you're not just saying that. You're not.
It's more lighting here. That's what it needs.
What a disaster. So much. It was late. The invitation to our guests barely went out at all. And it was so wonderful to prepare for a small banquet instead of the end of the world. Do you know what everyone is talking about tonight, from commoners to kings? Us. Dedas is discussing the success of the Inquisition.
You played no small part in our rise to power.
You had a role yourself, if I recall correctly. Truly, we will never forget those we lost. But for tonight, to victory.
Enjoying the refreshments? Josephine sent all the way to the capital for the petit four.
Cakes.
Oh, I love tiny cakes. And there's so many. Which should I try first?
I would avoid the dark ones topped with gold dust. Deep mushroom and anise. An awful combination. But it's quite popular in Val Royeux. I believe they call it the exquisite misery. Ole. Why did we save her again? To you, Inquisitor, for all you've done.
What's up, baby cakes?
I can't believe it's over. It seemed an impossible task. Defy the Chantry, build the Inquisition from nothing, defeat a creature that would be a god. And yet here we are, celebrating.
What's important is that you're here with me.
There was a moment after the orb exploded. I thought for certain you were dead. I prayed, don't take him from me, not after all we've been through. And then I saw you through the smoke. Sometimes the Maker is kind. I intend to rebuild the Seekers of Truth, to make us the order we were meant to be. That will take time. Meanwhile, I am free to remain here, with you. I think back to how we first met, and here you stand. You are the Inquisitor, a symbol of hope and change to so many. And you are the man I love. How did that happen, I wonder? Know that I will always stand with you.
Oh, get me all soft and shit.
So much to do, my dear. I'll be returning to Valguayu to organize the Loyalist Mages. The Empress requires my expertise during what is sure to be a difficult transition. But that will wait. Are you enjoying the celebration? Josephine was in a frenzy arranging it.
As a matter of fact, I am.
And well you should. It's a miracle we survived this ordeal. Go mingle. The night is still young.
Oh no, not yet. Let me just make sure I did everything. Is Dagna here? I'd like to thank Dagna. But I guess she's not. Alright. Well, it looks like I'm going to sleep by myself.
A moment before you go.
Ugh, exactly what I needed.
There's something else I wanted to say.
Oh? Lead on.
Oh, shit. Or it's morning.
What's this about?
Everything is about to change. You will be drawn in 100 different directions in the weeks and months to come.
Cassandra.
No, it's fine. I simply wanted to steal a moment while I still can.
It is said that Corypheus woke after his long slumber and found the world gone awry. He fought to bring back those days of magic and shadow, to raise himself as a god.
Where did she go anyway?
Now, we are left with a scar in the sky to remind us of what almost was. It tells us that a great victory against chaos was won, but left the world forever changed. Consider the mighty empire of Orlais, where Empress Selene remains on her golden throne. The civil war is ended, and order finally restored. The Empress is unchallenged. But at what price? Blood drips from Selene's hands, and all her court know it. However, none are in a position to move against her. As Orlais heals and its strength returns, relations with the Inquisition slowly sour. Icy receptions meet the Inquisition inside the Imperial Court, where most prefer that Orlais bow to no one, not even heroes. Many believe that when the Empire's fortunes wane once more, Selene will stand alone. The Grey Wardens of the South slowly rebuild in the months following the events at Adamant. They declare it time for the Order to emerge from the shadows, to join the rest of humanity in fighting their ancient foes. Rumors abound that they severed ties with their leaders at Weishaupt, and that a bitter war now rages between them. What becomes of Loghain is unknown, save that all news out of Weishaupt soon ends. Does the sudden silence indicate a battle within? Or something far worse. 1 month after the defeat of Corypheus, the Chantry names Leliana as successor to the Sunburst Throne.
Oh, shit.
Given the name Divine Victoria, she first declares an end to the Circle of Magi. The mages will now govern themselves. She opens the priesthood to other races, declares support for the Inquisition, and rededicates the Chantry to the principle of charity. Divine Victoria is controversial from the start. Several new sects arise, resisting her reforms and declaring her rule a threat to the faith. Her response is as swift as it is deadly. Unity is maintained, but blood runs through the halls of the Grand Cathedral. The Inquisition's mages, the former rebels led by Grand Enchanter Fiona, are left with a choice. When Leliana disbands the circles, they leave the Inquisition and reform the College of Enchanters as a new order. The College, they say, will allow mages of the South to gather in peace and seek new solutions to age-old problems. For the moment, it appears to be working. Mages are enjoying unprecedented acceptance throughout Thedas.
That's good. That can't just be it, right? She's gonna tell me more? Okay.
And what of the Inquisition itself? Its web of influence is felt in every hall. Through diplomacy and the trading of favors, it has gathered the power to shake kingdoms. I leave Skyhold now, knowing that power will continue to grow. The Inquisitor is a symbol to many, a leader of the changing world order. To others, he has become a target. They linger in the shadows, waiting for their day to come. When it does, the Inquisition shall stand ready.
That was a weird way of saying it.
I knew you would come. You should not have given your orb to Corypheus, Red Wolf.
Oh, shit.
I was too weak to unlock it after my slumber. The failure was mine. I should pay the price. But the people, they need me. I am so sorry.
I am sorry as well, old friend.
So, is she now in his body, I guess? This was... Where's my throne? Where are the tables? Okay. Alright, that was fun. I guess I'll, do something else, I guess. Alright.